Okay.
Maybe that can help.
Sure. Okay.
Sometimes you know you need to get something to hold something. I don't know.
All right, good morning, everybody. I'm here with Elena. Did I say it right?
Balestros.
Balestros.
Yeah.
And she is our
case manager
here at the YWCA South Florida Family Wellness Department. This is our first time meeting, so thank you for being here with us today. As you might know, it's October, and that means it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month. So we're here to talk about the importance of getting screened, some misconceptions around how often you go, what age you start going, why it's important, and if you wouldn't mind just telling me a little bit about how you got into this work, why it's important to you.
Okay, let me tell you first. I'm in the YWCA for 27 years, okay? In this September, I made 27 years. But anyway, from the YWCA, I started working since I was 15 years old in my country. When I came here, I started, I remember that, I checked the yellow pages, I found YWCA, I say, oh my gosh, my home is here. I come in and knock the door, and I started working in after school. I worked for many years in after school as an activity leader, as a director, whatever, I did many activities. And one day they offered to me to do case manager. I say, okay, case manager, you know, I can do. And it was to do about breast and cervical cancer. Try to find early detection, mm-hmm. breast and cervical cancer. I say, okay, because I have very bad time, my mom passed away with breast cancer. That's why I feel like I can help people.
Mm-hmm.
I can do something. And I started doing that 14 years ago. Case manager, you know, every time I help people, many people call me, many people know me, whatever. But I love my job because I know if you take care of one person, if you take care of a woman in the house, you take care of the whole family and the community.
That's awesome. Really appreciate you telling us about that. And I'm so sorry about your mom. And I know that's
great. It's sad. It's very sad. That was the thing to move from my country to this country. Because I cannot hold over there that lost. But, you know, God knows what to move, how to do.
May I ask where you're from? Where you're from?
I'm from Bolivia.
Oh, okay.
South America.
Yeah.
The heart of the South America.
Oh, I was curious. So if we could just talk about early detection. You mentioned early detection and prevention. What are some of the important things to know about that?
What happened is, you know, if you prevent, anyway, the cancer we can prevent. That come anytime, any people. We don't know exactly what's going on, mm-hmm. why they come. But if you detect early, that means if you detect the little thing in the breast, there's the step one, step zero.
Mm-hmm.
That person can be alive because they can take out everything, clean that area, and the person can still alive. But many people, you know, they live for years, years, years. And when they touch the breast, they found a big lump. When they found a big lump, can be something else, can be, you know, something really bad, mm-hmm. and it's very hard to handle that kind of
when it's advanced like that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But early detection is to do every year the mammogram,
mm-hmm.
From 40 to up.
Okay.
Sometimes the doctors decide to do mammogram early than 40 because they need that. But usually it's recommended to do 40 and up.
So maybe if you have, like, in your personal health history, like your family,
exactly.
then you might be a candidate for
exactly.
earlier.
Okay. Exactly. That is the thing.
Okay. And then as far as, you know, cervical cancer, do we have anything? I know there's the HPV vaccine. Is that something that we're still recommending?
That is very important to mm-hmm. have. You know, right now they do from 12 years old, girls and boys, mm-hmm. which is good because that avoids many, many illnesses. But, you know, we do only the pap test. And unfortunately, we don't have that many money to follow up when they need ultrasound and they need something else, but we refer that person to two different places.
Okay, so yeah, if you wouldn't mind telling us a little bit specifically about what we here at the YWCA do in our programs, how do we, so somebody, who's eligible, you know, who can come here for assistance?
Anybody, from 20 and up, I can tell you, I have some kids, some girls, mm-hmm. early than 15, under than 20, 15 years old. But what happened is, you know, when they found something or they have pain, they have to go to the doctor to see what happened. Mm-hmm. Through to 20 years, they have to go to the pediatric. After that, they can go to the primary doctor to see what happened. We do this. We do the CBE and PAP, the CBE clinic breast examination. We send it to the doctor. The doctor check the breast. If the person needs some follow-up, like mammogram, ultrasound, whatever, then we do. The YWCA help to do CBE PAP, follow-up with a screening mammogram or breast ultrasound, and if those come out normal, we continue help them until we got the person done.
Wow, that's amazing. That's awesome. And so is it, I mean, is there a cost associated? Is it, you know, do you need insurance? Is it just, it's anybody?
Okay. You know, sometimes we help the people who has insurance, mm-hmm. but they have to pay very high copayments mm-hmm. that people cannot afford. We help them. But usually we have people who doesn't have any insurance and low income. That is the way to help the community with low income and no insurance.
Yeah.
Or no health insurance.
And would you say, are there connections with, you know, certain demographics having higher instances? Because, so what I wanted to mention, the as far as equity, right, in health and equity and equality, not everybody has, you know, everybody has a different genetic predisposition, but there's other external factors that might make it worse, right? So if somebody, certain populations in our area present with a more advanced stage, and is this because they can't afford to go regularly, or they don't have insurance?
Or usually, you know, they don't want to go to the doctor. They don't want to let them touch the breast, the cervical area, but they have to do. They have to do this. It's something for their health.
Yeah.
You know, the people have to go. We have more Hispanic because probably it's Miami. We have American people, Black, Haiti, American Black. You know, we have diversity.
Mm-hmm.
We have everyone. Whoever comes to us, we help. If we cannot do from the YWCA to pay, I refer any other place. We have different places. For example, I have only one doctor so far in Opa-locka Medua Medical Center. They have connection with two different hospitals, Memorial Hospital and Baptist Hospital. What happened is, if my patient came to me to say, okay, I need to do CV and PAP, I refer them, they check. If that person really, really needs something else, no simple mammogram or simple ultrasound, they took them to the hospital. In the hospital, they check, they develop cancer, and in the hospital, they take care of them. Or if that person comes to us, I say, okay, you need something else. For example, you need to go to check your eyes or you check your teeth, whatever. I check and I refer somewhere, some places.
Okay, that's awesome. I really appreciate that, you explaining that to me and to everybody who might need those services. What if someone's afraid to go to the doctor, or if somebody doesn't feel comfortable, do we have, you know, are there doctors and medical professionals in our community that might, you know, help put them at ease? Like maybe, you know, maybe if I'm Latinx, right, and I want to go to a Latinx doctor. How do we go about finding that? Is that something we have? I mean, do you know?
I know what you mean. At this moment, I am by myself in the program, okay? I try to do the most I can.
Mm-hmm.
But I see The MedOne Medical Center helped me a lot because they have doctors, they have professional people. That way I go to them and they help me. Whatever they need, they try to do, you know, we try to help them the most easy we can do for them.
Okay. What would you say to people who are afraid to go? How would you convince somebody, you know?
I talk to them. You know what, let me tell you something. I have one patient 2 years ago, probably, I don't remember the time, and she doesn't want to go. She said, no, Miss Alina, because I have something, they push my friend, they do something. I said, please go. Call again. Finally, she went, and she developed cancer. Now, she called me many times to thank you for saving her life. You see, that happened because when you feel something, you tell them. Another time, well, this was amazing history. I don't like to do interviews. Last year, they told me, you have to come because we have to do it. Okay, I say, I'm coming. You know, like pushing. I got here, and the person who interviewed me, like you, we are talking about, blah, 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 the same as we are talking. When I saw her, I say, okay, you know what? I have my examples, which I can bring today because I don't know. I show her, I said, look, don't let your breast go this big lump, because this big lump can be something else. If you find this little one, okay, we can take care of you with the mammogram, with something, whatever. Finished my interview, next time she called me. She had a big lump in her breast.
Wow.
She said, I don't know where I can go. I don't know what I can do. I don't have insurance. I have part-time. My husband lost his job. And we have her. Thanks God, she didn't have any bad things. No, she didn't have cancer, but I have her.
That's amazing.
I say, okay, God, let me come here because I don't want to come. I told Natalie, Natalie, please don't call me, don't tell me. I don't like that because I know I'm the only one person, but unfortunately, I don't like to leave the news to say the
well,
same.
Well, I really appreciate it because it is such an important topic and it is something that we need to talk about more.
I feel sometimes I say that they have to know what we are doing. They have to see what I am doing. That's why I say, Natalie, I'm doing this and this and this. Go tell them.
Well, thank you so much. Mm-hmm. I really, really appreciate
it. It's my pleasure.
I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day.